What's up, Charisma crew? This is your captain speaking. Season 4 of Halo Infinite just keeps delivering bangers.
Banger! After banger! After banger! After banger! After banger! After banger!
This time with Husky Raid officially returning to Halo Infinite. As one of my favorite modes to play in Halo 5, I am so happy to see it return. I thought I'd make a quick video with my thoughts on the game, but before we do that, I'm in the race to get my first 1k subscribers. Less than 9% of you are subscribed to the channel, so if you enjoy Halo content, please consider subscribing so we can grow the Charizzma crew. If you guys remember, I made a video a few months ago talking about the cool Husky Raid maps the community had made, and I'll leave a link for you guys to check it out. Although none of those maps made it into this playlist, we still received a fantastic playlist with 8 new stunning maps. They've all got their own unique charm to them. We've got Corpo, Diminished, my personal favorite, Megapolis, Ronin, Scarlet's Landing, Small Hala, Aqueduct, and finally Disciple. Honestly, I probably butchered some of those names, but you guys know what I'm talking about. The reason I love Megapolis the most is because of its cyberpunk theme and simple layout. The sneaky balcony area is a great touch and a cool way to sneak up on the enemy team. There is one thing that Halo 5's Husky Raid had that Halo Infinite is missing, and that is weapon variants. For some reason, the game doesn't give you the campaign variants of the weapons, which would make it so much more fun to play. I really hope this is updated and added into the future. Equipment, on the other hand, really mixes things up and changes how the game is played compared to Halo 5. Repulsor comes in handy to deflect rockets, enemies with melee weapons, or to get to some tricky spots. The combination of the recently increased radius of the threat sensor and small maps in this playlist make it extremely effective at finding campers. Drop wall is great for putting down quick cover when pushing into the other side, using it for boom blocks, or just when sniping from your base. Thruster is okay for a quick evade, but probably not as effective as the others for this specific game mode. Shroud screen, on the other hand, really shines in Husky Raid and can be used to block line of sight and move towards the enemy side when they can't see you. And then, the grapple shot. It's easily the most powerful equipment. For some reason, you can grapple while holding the flag, so if you have the grapple shot and grab the flag, you can just yeet out of there extremely quickly and make an easy flag capture. It's almost too OP, but it's not too big of a deal, honestly. Husky Raid is a fun party game mode, and it doesn't need to be that serious. Speaking of fun party game mode, it does make me wonder how strict the MMR is for this playlist. It feels like every time I play a game where I do really well, the next game just feels infinitely more challenging, but I guess that's just every playlist. But what do you guys think of Husky Raid? Are you enjoying it? Let me know in the comments down below. If you enjoyed the video, Superman punch that like button and subscribe for more Halo content. I'll see you guys in the next one.
Subscribe to Kaptain Karizzma.